Many of us have spent a lot of time on Zoom over the past few years, but unfortunately, a lot of our experience
looks and sounds like a garbled, blurry mess.
So today, let's get set to clear things up in your Zoom settings to help your meetings look and sound their best. In fact, let's zoom right into it. So today we're not gonna go through every single Zoom setting because that would take like 12 years. Instead, we're just gonna focus on the ones that will help you improve the quality of your audio, your video, your screen shares, and your recordings. And there really are two categories of things we can change to improve the quality of your Zoom meetings, software and hardware. And we're gonna start with software because these are settings that you can change right now in the app that will absolutely amaze you. And then after that, we can take it a step further by talking about equipment. Now, as you probably know, within Zoom, there are two ways to change your settings. One is within the app, and the other is through a browser. The browser has a lot more settings. Some of the settings overlap, some don't. It's kind of a weird mess. So let's start first with the settings that I recommend you change in the app itself. First thing, under the video tab, be sure to enable the HD option right down there, and then don't select touch up my appearance and adjust for low light. Those sound like good things, but again, those are designed for really terrible situations. And if you're using any kind of decent equipment, those tools are just gonna make you look like a mall glamour portrait from 1986. So for now, that's all we're gonna touch in the video tab is making sure that HD is enabled. And now we're gonna go this way and click on audio. I'm gonna say adios to video and click on audio. Yo. The first thing to do is to disable automatically adjust microphone volume. For me, I always use the Rodecaster Pro with my Zoom meetings, but even some USB microphones have software that works with them, or you might be using something like Ecamm or OBS where you can adjust your audio levels, or you can just use this little slider right here to adjust your audio level. The reason you probably don't want to use the automatic microphone volume adjustment is because it can make things change volume in ways that sound very unnatural. So if you're controlling your volume through a physical mixer or some other software application, you don't need that. If you are unsure of your mixing abilities or you're not quite sure how volume's gonna be working, it is okay, of course, to leave that checked. But in general, you're gonna get better quality if you're the one adjusting your volume. And typically, you just wanna make sure that your volume is right about halfway in the green over there. You don't want it to be peaking at the end, and you don't want it to be super quiet where it's not even showing up at all. If it's in the red and yellow, that means it's not loud enough. And if it were to be too loud, it would be peaking on the other side over there. Fortunately, as you take a peek over there, my audio is not peaking. Up next, we have the option to suppress background noise, and I just keep that on low. And what that means is it's designed for a situation where you really don't have a lot of background noise, but what that's actually telling Zoom to do is to not use so much of its very aggressive filter that's gonna try to filter out noise. That's where things really start to sound garbled, and you almost sound like you're underwater sometimes because it's trying to get rid of every distracting noise that there is. The next option is probably the most important when it comes to audio, and I am assuming that you're gonna be using an external microphone. I would consider that a non-negotiable if you wanna have a high quality Zoom meeting. What that means is in here where it says music and professional audio, check the box that says show in meeting option to enable original sound. And typically I just leave these other options all unchecked. High fidelity music mode is important if you're doing something that involves you sharing a lot of music, but otherwise echo cancellation, I would just leave off, and stereo audio, you probably want to leave off unless you have a really specific reason that you want certain sounds coming from certain sides of other people's headphones or speakers. And now with that setting turned on, when I'm in a Zoom meeting, up here in the corner, there's a thing that says original sound off or on, and you want to turn original sound on, and basically what that's going to do, it says, is disable all of Zoom's audio processing. The reason I say it's supposed to do that is because I still think that I do hear some processing and some weird stuff happening even when original sound is turned on, but it does sound significantly better. So in theory, if you're using original sound, all of these other audio settings shouldn't matter because those things should be turned off when you're using original sound. But with Zoom, I have found that it's best to just play it extra safe and try to adjust everything as best you can. Unless I'm the only person who's ever had weird things happen during a Zoom meeting. I'm sure for everybody else, it's always worked perfectly. And now in the application, we can go over to share screen. The first thing to do here is to click on advanced and make sure that you have use hardware acceleration to optimize video sharing enabled. Typically, Zoom resolution is bad, but screen sharing is one thing that does get bumped up to 1080 full high definition. And from there, we're going to go into the recording tab, because a lot of people who run Zoom meetings or participate in Zoom meetings need to have recordings of the meetings. And the first thing to do, if you haven't done so already, is select a location where your recordings are going to go, because a lot of people don't know where their recordings are being stored. And when the meeting's over, they lose it and they have to search through their whole computer. So right here where it says store my recordings, you can click there and choose a new location. Personally, I like to choose the desktop because as soon as the meeting is over, it puts the file right there on the desktop and then I have to deal with it right away. And I think that that works really well if you're somebody who does something like workshops or classes where you need to post a replay of a Zoom meeting as quickly as possible. And another thing in the recording tab that might be really important is the option to optimize for a third-party video editor. It's usually a good idea just to have that option checked, even if you don't plan on using that, because it's better to need it and not have it than, no wait, it's better to have it and not need it than need it and not have it. So that's pretty much everything we need to change within the app, but there are some more really important settings to change within the browser, which opens up a whole new world of possibilities. There are two easy ways to log into your browser settings. The first one is just to go to Zoom's website, zoom.us, log into your account, and then go to settings. Or from within the application, you can click on your profile picture and then click on My Profile. And then we'll open up a browser window where you can just select on settings. And then we have a lot more stuff to play with over here. And some features that you're able to change do depend on what kind of Zoom account you have. Obviously, the free account is going to be the most limited, while the different paid accounts will have different features. I have the Pro account, which, despite its name, has a lot of cons to it. But it is the cheapest paid account, and for the most part, it lets me do pretty much everything I wanna do. So once we're in settings, up here at the top is where we have all of our different tabs. Let's start actually with the recording tab this time. An important thing to do in the recording tab is to decide how you want your recordings to appear if you're doing screen shares. You have some different options here, like record active speaker with the shared screen, so that means it's going to be the screen share with the person who's talking, but you can also record gallery view if you want to see the screen share and a bunch of people who are in the meeting, or you can record them separately, the active speaker, the gallery view, and the screen share if you plan on editing those together and switching them up later on. That's kind of a cool thing. You also have some really cool audio options here, including isolated audio tracks. You can record a separate audio file of each participant, which is great if you have a meeting and suddenly somebody has themselves unmuted and they do something really distracting. You can just get rid of that and save the audio from the speaker that you actually want to hear from. So now that we've got a recording set up, let's go back into the meeting tab. And right now we're going to go to In Meeting Advanced. You can also just scroll down. There's just sort of like this infinite scroll here that's gonna take you through all these different sections, or you can shortcut click to go straight through them. Now in the In Meeting Advanced section, if we scroll down a little bit more, there's this option right here, which is hugely important, and that is Group HD Video. So this is going to enable high definition video for the host and the participants of a meeting, but there is kind of an asterisk there. And notice right here, mine says modified. If we go to Zoom's plans and pricing, even if we look at the most expensive option, the enterprise option, none of these say anything about video resolution. So if you want to make sure that you always have HD and the highest resolution possible for your account, you actually need to reach out to Zoom technical support, and I will walk you through that exact process right now. So the first step is just to go back to the Zoom homepage. You can go to zoom.us and then scroll all the way down to the bottom and click on Support Center. Once you're in the support center, scroll down again and go all the way to technical support and click on learn more. Do not use the chat icon over here. If you scroll down, you're going to see some different phone numbers. You can definitely give them a call and they will help you over the phone. I am a shy person who hates talking on the phone, so I did the web ticket request and it worked great. Do not use the chat bot because it is a bot, so all it's going to do is try to point you to articles to help you solve your problem on your own, and you can't do that. So if you open a web ticket request, you can do technical support. The web ticket was super fast and easy to use for me. I received a response in less than an hour, and that was on a Sunday night, so I was actually very impressed with that. They kind of hide the option to actually talk to someone, but once you find it, they're super responsive and super helpful. So here's what I wrote in my request. Feel free to copy it. It is very important to include your account number, which can be found in your profile page, either in the app or the browser. Now, as soon as I got my response back, they said, no problem, your account's been upgraded to 720. And I said, great, that's awesome. But it is 2022 at the time I'm recording this video. What about full 1080? And they said that my account, the pro plan, only goes up to 720, and it's the other accounts, the higher end ones, that go up to full 1080. So this is a feature that definitely does depend on which account you have, but if you have one of the higher end accounts, then you can have full 1080 all the time in Zoom. But now let's also talk about hardware updates, equipment updates that you can implement as needed as possible for your workflow. We're gonna spend a ton of time on specific equipment, but I will leave links in the description to the stuff that I recommend specifically for Zoom. The first thing, which I think is non-negotiable regardless of your budget, is getting an external microphone for Zoom. Please do not use a built-in microphone. I don't care what computer you're using, how good you think the built-in microphone is, even if you change nothing else in terms of hardware, please get a good microphone. That's going to make everything so much better for you and everybody else that you interact with on Zoom. That can be a simple USB mic like this. This is the Rode NT USB Mini, or you could go full on, you know, mixer interface, XLR microphone, whole production sound studio. Even if you get a pretty basic like $30 or $40 USB microphone, it's really going to level up the quality of your audio. And when it comes to video, believe it or not, audio is significantly more important than the video quality. And it's also very important, once you have that microphone, spend a little bit of time and learn how to use it. Don't just plug it in, set it down, and assume now you're gonna sound amazing, because you probably won't. Do you need to get something like a boom arm? Do you need to get a little stand to put it on? Do some test recordings and some test meetings to see what sounds the best. Play with some of your Zoom settings and dial that in before you just try to use it on a meeting without ever having tested it before, because I promise you something will go wrong if you do that. Now, if we do want to move on from audio and level up the quality of video, please just stop using webcams. They do have a place. If you just want clear video and that's it, they can get the job done. But if you want to take it a little bit further and have something that looks just nicer and stands out a bit more, a webcam will never get the job done for you. No webcam, no application, nothing will ever look as good as a camera with an interchangeable lens. Now, I actually talked a lot about this in my live streaming tips and tricks video, so I'm gonna link that right here and in the description if you want more detail on which kind of cameras and why it makes a difference. There's a lot of overlap between best practices for Zoom and for live streaming, because in a lot of ways, when you're running a good Zoom meeting, you're basically doing a live stream. Now, up next, I would be delighted to talk about lighting. I have a full-on studio with 14 lights on right now, so it looks pretty decent, and my Zoom meetings look pretty good. They basically look just like this because I use all the same equipment for them. But you don't have to get a studio with 14 lights. You just need to pay a little bit of attention to your lighting. So here's an example. Let's turn all these off. I'm totally blowing my whole point because this kind of looks cool in a way, although the white balance is totally off. But a lot of times what people do is they walk into a room, they flip on an overhead light, and they're done. I am using a $4,000 camera with a $1,500 lens, so even this less than ideal lighting situation kind of looks nice. So at the very least, what you want is a good key light, a good main light. That could be a dedicated video light, or it might just be something you have around that you position in a different way, bouncing off a wall or something. There we go, I was waiting for mine to turn on. My key light is a dedicated video light and it's very bright, but even if I only have this one light on, it makes things look a lot nicer. And you will need to spend some time positioning your key light to look good. I have mine bouncing off of a wall so that it's not shining in my face all day, because that would drive me crazy. And it's also running through a small softbox, so that way the light is diffused and really soft. But I'll put some budget-friendly lighting options in the description too. But for my setup, in addition to just this one light, I also have a fill light over there to kind of fill things in a little bit. I even have a light mounted to the ceiling behind me, which is a hair light or a backlight. And what that does is help separate me from the background a little bit. It's really unnecessary, but it's one of those small details that really pushes things over the top. So now you kind of see I have like some shine to my hair. There's some light on my shoulders here, so that way I'm not just totally blending in to my background. And speaking of backgrounds, be sure to pay attention to your background for your meeting. Even if you just have a plain wall, sometimes that's the best option. Try to put some distance between yourself and the background, because that way it's not gonna look like someone just shoved you up against a wall. It's gonna kind of give some depth to it. Even just a few feet or like a meter would make a pretty big difference. I think over the past few years, as we've seen lots of people on TV doing interviews from their houses, a lot of people love to have bookshelves behind them, which is super cool. It's a great way to showcase your personality and add some texture. But some people do not pay attention to which books are on their bookshelves, and there are some weird books out there that are on people's bookshelves that I don't think they're intending for the audience to pay attention to. So just remember, everything that's in the frame has the potential to grab somebody's attention. And once you have a pretty background setup, usually then adding in some accent lights can really help. Even something simple like this little lamp right here makes a pretty big difference in my situation. I have some lights in my cabinet so that it's not just totally dark, but I've also got all kinds of other little accent lights that all work together to create the look that I want for my videos and my meetings. Now, the good news is you don't have to zoom out and buy a whole bunch of new stuff for Zoom right now. You can kind of cherry pick some of these options. If you go through and you just address a few of the things that I've talked about in this video, you're going to notice a significant improvement in the quality of your meetings, and you can add or update things later on, or not at all, depending on what works best for you. But if you're somebody who spends a lot of time on Zoom, having a setup that really looks good, looks professional, sounds good, really helps you stand out and just look and sound awesome. And speaking of things that stand out and are awesome, thank you to everyone who helps support my channel through Patreon and YouTube channel memberships. And now that you're looking and sounding awesome on Zoom, check out these videos for some more ways to level up your Zoom experience. Your Zoom experience.